As we discussed in a standard Ethernet, what we were doing, we were simply connecting our Ethernet, and speed is very less, right? Mostly 10 Mbps, and so many other types are also there, so many different cables we were using during that connection, right? So now today we'll discuss about fast as well as gigabit Ethernet and 10 gigabit Ethernet. So simply, it is an extension of the previous Ethernet. Simply, in the new Ethernet, we are increasing the size of or speed of the Ethernet. That's it. So let's start with fast Ethernet. So this is a mistake. I can say send speed of the fast Ethernet is 100 Mbps, not 1000 Mbps. If we consider 1000, then simply it will convert in gigabit Ethernet. So here it is my mistake. Fast Ethernet speed is 100 Mbps. So what are the goal of fast Ethernet? So today, in today's lecture, basically I'll explain the goal and the different types of cable, whatever we are using during this connection. And what kind of encoding techniques we are using, that I'll discuss today, right? So, what is the goal of fast Ethernet? Upgrade the data rate 200 Mbps, right? So, previous data rate was 10 Mbps. So, here I am upgrading 10 times, right? So, upgrade the data rate 100 Mbps, make it compatible with the standard Ethernet, right? So keep the same 46 48-bit address, right? So address bit should be same 48-bit. So basically, in terms of 6 bytes, we are representing. Keep the same frame format. So now you maybe you understood that why I took too much of time in the standard Ethernet, because everything is same whenever we are dealing with fast Ethernet or gigabit Ethernet. Simply here we are increasing the speed. That's it. So 48-bit address is also same. Frame format is also same. Now more speed, right? So if we are increase the speed, then maybe chances of collision may increase, right? So for that, in previous Ethernet we were using bus topology, but here we will use the passive hub or star topology, right? So it is useful, because whenever we are using hub technology, at that time chances of collision decrease. Why? Because in bus topology, our transmission medium or line is only one, so each and every station can start a transmission at a time. But in star topology, one hub is there, either it is active hub or passive hub. One hub is there, so it will hold this all the packet and check that, okay, which is the destination address of this packet. So collision chances of collision is decreased whenever we are using hub or star topology. Now inside the fast Ethernet, some different concept are there. First one is use link layer switch. Here also we are using switch. If you go through the previous lecture, then switch concept is also I discussed, right? So what we are doing in switch, we are mentioning two different lines. First line is for sender and second line for receiver. Let's say one switch is there, with that switch one node is connected, then two separate lines we are maintaining, one for transmission from host to switch, and second one is receive for from host to host to switch, right? So this is if we use the switch approach, then definitely our collision chances will decrease. So use the link layer switch with a buffer to store the frame. Let's say if host speed is more as compared to switch speed, so at that time we are maintaining one buffer also to store it and to reduce the packet loss chances, right? And here we are using full duplex. In previous scenario, we were mostly using with half duplex. Half duplex means what? At a time, only one can send the data, or means either it can send the data or it can receive the data. But here we are using full duplex connection, and transmission medium private for each host, right? So I already mentioned and explained the switch scenario as in Ethernet, so please go through that scenario, right? One new terminology we added in fast Ethernet, that is auto negotiation. What do you mean by auto negotiation? Two devices means, first, simply, what do you mean by negotiation? We can negotiate, right? In I can say bargain means kind of bargain, right? So here also two devices can bargain, means two devices to negotiate the node or data rate of operation, means they can mutually synchronize and they can negotiate the speed or data rate. So it is a good thing over here because 10 Mbps, sorry, 100 Mbps is very high speed. So maybe either sender or receiver is not comfortable with this speed, right? So at that time they can decrease the speed. If speed is very less, then they can increase the speed, but it should be followed by the means negotiation terminologies, right? So several changes need to made on physical layer. Why? Because here also we are increasing the speed, we are using
excuse me ma'am, Prerin is trying to listen to the meeting, ma'am.
But it's already 2:05, so I cannot allow
no,
this.
He's trying from past 5 minutes or something, ma'am.
Okay, great. Happy? So now, what changes we should made on physical layer? First one is we are using different nodes, right, on physical layer. So we are using different devices, like previously we were using bus topology, we are using different topologies. As nowadays we are using star topology whenever we are dealing with fast ethernet, right? And connection also different, means star topology and switch connection we are using in a fast ethernet, right? In implementation also at that in standard ethernet we discuss different types, right? 10 base something, right? 10 base F, 10 base T. So I already discussed what do you mean by 10 base and X, right? So here also whenever we are dealing with this fast ethernet at that time also some different three types of implementation are there. First one is 100 base TX. What do you mean by 100 base TX? Means 100 means 100 Mbps speed, base means baseband means digital transmission, and TX means what? Twisted pair cable we are using over here, right? So two pairs of twisted pair cable we are using. Speed is 125 Mbps. This is the maximum speed. Minimum is 100 Mbps. Maximum we can get is 125 Mbps. And this is the encoding technique. MLT3 is an encoding technique. Now, second one is 100 base FX. FX means what? Previous in standard Ethernet, I already discussed whenever we are dealing with F, then it is a fiber, right? Fiber optics or optical fiber, whenever we are using at the time, we can say that it is a FX. So here we are using two pairs of fiber optical cables, right? And encoding technique, previously we were using MLT3 encoding, and here I'm using NRZI encoding schema, right? And speed is 100 to 125. So here speed is not that much change. Previously also whenever I'm using twisted pair at that time maximum I can get 125, and here also whenever I'm using fiber optics or optical fiber at that time also I'm getting 100 to 125 Mbps. Now next one is, yes, but what is the difference between fiber optics and optical twisted pair? In fiber optics, okay, maximum bandwidth is fixed till 125 Mbps I can send, but collision chances is decreased as compared to twisted pair. So okay, in both the cases data rate is same, but still if they have given the choice, then we will definitely go with fiber optic cable, right? Now third type is 100 base T4. T4 means what? Whenever T is there at that time, I can call as it's a twisted pair, right? So four pair of twisted pair cables we are using whenever we are dealing with this 100 base T4. Now, but it is a more complicated. Why? Because previously in both the cases, 100 base TX and 100 base FX, we are using only two wires, right? But here we are using four wire cables for connection purpose. So that's why means it is more complex, right? 100 Mbps to 75 M board signal. So previous lectures or whenever we before lockdown, I already discussed this mega board, what is boat. For that, I took the example of vehicle and number of passengers, right? Or number of travelers, right? So let's say if I'm using one Activa, then what data I can send in that Activa and how many vehicles I have to use, right? So I already discussed this, what is baud rate. So for that, you can revise that, right? So maximum sizes, maximum data rate is 100 Mbps to 75 megabauds. So here I summarize all three types of implementation in fast Ethernet. First one is 100 base TX, second one is 100 base FX, third one is 100 base T4. And medium also, mostly we are using UTP means unshielded twisted pair, or STP is shielded twisted pair, fiber and UTP, right? So this is a medium length, means whenever we are dealing with this kind of, let's say I'm considering this 100 base TX, then what is the range of that particular network is 100 meter. And how many wires I'm using, two wires I'm using, and what kind of encoding I'm using, MLT3 or 4B, 5B, right? So NRZI, that you already know, right? NRZI, NRZL, then what is NRZ, Manchester, differential Manchester, this kind of this is all of these are encoding techniques. So here also we are using different kind of encoding, right? In 100 base T4 we are using 2 8B 6T technique as a encoding, right? Now we will start with gigabit Ethernet. As the name suggests, what do you mean by gigabit? Here, sorry, my mistake. It is 1000 Mbps, right? Not 100. It is 1000 Mbps, or 1 Gbps is the speed of that Ethernet. So basically, what we are doing, one by one, we are increasing the speed of the Ethernet. In standard Ethernet, 10 Mbps, then 100 Mbps, then 1000 Mbps, and the next one is 10 gigabit Ethernet. So one by one, simply we are increasing the speed, but in terms of address or in terms of frame format, we are not doing any changes, right? So here also, what is this 802.3Z? Means 802. I already discussed 802 means what? It is a IEEE standard. So according to IEEE standard, different terminologies and different devices have given a unique number system. So for gigabit Ethernet, they are using 802.3Z. Now, address length, frame format, and minimum maximum frame length is same. So here frame length is same, but simply we are increasing the speed. That's it. Or speed, or I can say data rate, right? So address, frame format, and minimum maximum frame length is same. What are the design goal of this gigabit Ethernet? First one is upgrade the data rate, right? 1 Gbps. Obvious goal that we have to upgrade the data rate. Then compatible with the standard or fast Ethernet, right? So no need to, means whenever we are increasing the size or increasing the data rate, at that time no need to change any infrastructure or anything, right? It should be compatible with previous versions. So then and then user will use it, right? Or else if you have to again establish whole network, then no point that user will use that, right? So it is compatible with standard and fast Ethernet. So if we will deal with 10 gigabit Ethernet, then also it is compatible with standard, fast and gigabit, right? So it should be compatible with previous version, right? Third one is 48 bits address size. I already discussed that address size is same, frame format is also same, and keep the same min max frame length, right? So I already discussed that what are the minimum frame length and what are the maximum, what are the preamble SFD whenever we are dealing with standard or any kind of Ethernet, right? So please go through that video first. And last goal of gigabit Ethernet is support auto negotiation like fast Ethernet, right? So this is a good technique. Auto negotiation is nothing but we sender and receiver or two hosts can negotiate the speed as well as environment. Anything they want to negotiate, they can auto negotiation, and it is supported by fast Ethernet, and here also in gigabit Ethernet also will support this concept, right? Now MAC layer. Why we are using MAC layer and LLC layer? They that part also I explained, that whenever you want only multicast at the time, only one sublayer is used. Whenever you want broadcast at the time, all two sublayer, MAC sublayer as well as LLC sublayer is used, right? So keep the MAC sublayer untouched. Means here I am not changing anything in MAC sublayer, but one thing I am changing. Previously, I already discussed in standard Ethernet, I am using only half duplex, and in fast Ethernet as well as gigabit Ethernet, I am using full duplex, right? So what is full duplex? Mostly used in gigabit, right? Whenever I am using full duplex, no need of CSMA/CD protocol. Why? Because at a time, sender can send also and receive also. Means acknowledgement concept is there whenever I'm using full duplex, right? So no need of collision detection, because if user or sender will not get the acknowledgement, then it will easily identify that, okay, my packet is somewhere collided or something happened to my packet. So easily it can send the packet, right? So now the maximum length of the cable is determined by the signal attenuation in the cable. Yes. What do you mean by attenuation? Means whenever I'm using transmission impairments, you have written, right? Three types of transmission impairments: attenuation, distortion, and noise, right? So attenuation is nothing but whenever signal will lose their power or energy, at that time I can call as attenuation. So in this point, we want some devices, right? Repeater. So it will increase the energy of the signal, right? Now, next one is whenever we are using half duplex, switch is replaced with hub, right? Because whenever in previous lecture, I discussed whenever I'm using switch, at the time, two separate links I'm using. And in whenever I'm using hub, single link I'm using. So whenever I'm using half duplex, hub is used, and whenever I'm using full duplex, switch is used, right? So in half duplex, common cable is there, right? So collision might occur. And in half duplex, obviously collision occur, then we will require a CSMA/CD, all the concept we have to use there, right? Now, what is the minimum length of the frame? I already discussed that same minimum and maximum frame length is same. But here, if you want to change the frame, then it's possible in gigabit Ethernet. Basically, it is same as a fast Ethernet and previous concept, standard Ethernet. But here, if you want to change, then how you can change? So three types are there of minimum length. First one is traditional. Second one is carrier extension. Third one is frame bursting. Now, first one is traditional, right? So what do you mean by traditional? That you already know, right? That minimum frame length is like a traditional one, 512 bits, right? So maximum user can send is 512 bits. That is a frame length. So if I want to calculate the slot, then 512 divided by, let's say, 100 is my slots, right? So zero means slot time is 0.512 microsecond. And 100 times earlier, collision detection as compared to previous means whenever I'm using this traditional frame approach, at that time, collision detection is also faster because we are sending the frame, means speed of the frame or speed of the packet is increased. So collision detection is also faster, right? Now, next one is carrier extension. Means previously I was using 512 bits as a frame, right? And here I'm using minimum length is equal to 512 bytes. So it is 8 times, right? Because if I'll multiply bit with byte, then I have to multiply with 8, right? So it is a 512 bytes. So minimum length 8 times longer, right? Whenever I'm using carrier extension. And maximum length of the network is 200 meters. Yes. Whenever I'm using this traditional approach, minimum length of the network is 100 meter. But here I increase the length of the network, right? So it is a 200 meter. And whenever I'm using this carrier extension approach, at the time, I have to use hub, means star topology. So why 100 meter from the hub to station? Why we are using this 200 meter? Because hub is in between, right? And with hub, so many other devices are connected, right? So that's why our network size is 200 meter and distance between host and hub is 100 meter. Now, third type is frame bursting. So whenever why we come up with this kind of concept. Many time, let's say if frame size is very small, then what will happen? User have to add some extra bits in the frame size. So it is not a good, right? Why have to why should I pad the extra bit to my frame, right? So instead of padding the some unnecessary bits, I can also pad the useful, or I can combine the frames, right? So when the frame size is small, extra bit is stuffed, right? I already discussed. Now, instead of adding an extension, send the multiple frames. So that concept I can call as frame busting. Means instead of sending that extra padding bits, I can send the two frames at a time. Two frames I can send at a time. That time I can call as frame busting. So padding is done between these two frames. Okay, whenever I'm sending two frames, at that time padding must be there. Padding means what? To differentiate between these two frames, I have to add some extra bits, right? 0, 0, 0 or 1, 1, 1, so that user can, means receiver can easily identify that, okay, one frame is done, second frame. So in one shot, sender has sent two frames, right? So for that, some padding bits is used. But it is good as compared to previous approach, right? In previous approach, we are simply padding the extra zeros and extra ones. So it is not a good thing. Here I'm sending two frames at a time with some extra padded bits in between the two frames, right? Now, I'll also discuss the what are the different type of implementation whenever I'm using bit Ethernet, right? Gigabit Ethernet. So physical layer, I already discussed that star topology is used. In only standard Ethernet, we are using bus topology. After that, we are every time we are using star topology. Here is different implementation summary, right? So here is different types. First one is 1000 base SX. Second one is 1000 base LX. Third one is 1000 base CX and 1000 base T4. So now what is this SX, LX, CX and T4, right? So SX means short wave, LX means long wave, CX means shielded twisted pair, and T4 means four wire twisted pair I'm using. So in exam, if they'll ask any kind of this kind of implementation type, then simply you will remember this table, and from table you can directly write the theory. Means basically you have to write this 3, 4, 5 points, right? That what is this 100, what is this 1000 over here, what is this base, what is this SX represent, what kind of medium I'm using, right? So here I'm using fiber short wave, fiber long wave, STP means shielded twisted pair, unshielded twisted pair, right? So different medium I'm using. After that, medium length you have to remember. First one is 550 meter, means what is the exact length of my particular this kind of network, right? So for that I'm using different meters. After that I'm using different wires. How many wires I can use? How many wires I can use, right? So in previous three approaches, I'm using only two wires. But in last T4, as the name suggests, I'm using four approaches. And encoding. How encoding will work in this implementation summary? I already discussed everywhere. In first three terminologies, we are using this NRZ approach. With NRZ, I'm using 8B, 10B, right? So no need to go in that much detail that what is this 8-bit 10B, but simply you have to remember that 8-bit 10B is one kind of encoding technique, right? And in last 1000 base T4, I'm using 4D PAN5. It is a type of one type of encoding technique. And as the name suggests, 1000 base T4, in that I'm using four wires, right? And last one, 10 gigabit Ethernet. So goal of 10 gigabit Ethernet, I can easily explain that in that it should be compatible with previous three types and same address, same frame size, everything is same. But according to that IEEE standard, it should be 802.3AE, right? So I can represent this 10 gigabit Ethernet with 802.3AE, right? Simply what we are doing over here in 10 gigabit Ethernet, simply we are increasing the size of the data rate, right? So data rate is increased, means what? Simply sender can send more data at a time, right? Now remaining goal implementation type is somewhat different whenever I'm dealing with this 10 gigabit Ethernet. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also four kind of implementation are there. 10G means 10 gigabit base, SR, LR, EW, and X4, right? And here also, everywhere we are using fiber optics. In previous example, I already mentioned that if we have given the option between twisted pair and fiber optics, then easily we will choose the fiber optics. Why? Because in fiber optics, there is a very less chance of, means it is a faster as well as very less chance of collision, right? So that's why I'm using medium as a fiber optics. All four implementation type, I'm using a medium as a fiber optics only. This is the medium length. If you can carefully observe that previously our medium length is in meters only, but in this medium length is kilometer in terms of kilometer, right? So 10 kilometer, 40 kilometer. So our medium length or our length of network is increased as compared to a previous one. Why we increase the medium length over here? Because our speed is more, so we can easily utilize the means we can easily deal with a big network, or I can say wide network, right? And here in terms of wires, everywhere I'm using two wires only. And in terms of encoding, 64B66B, this is another type of encoding. SONET is also a type of encoding. In computer networks, maybe you will learn what is this SONET encoding and how it will work. And last one is 8B10B is also an encoding type. So if they'll ask in exam that explain a gigabit Ethernet, bit Ethernet, then you have to remember this table everywhere for each and every Ethernet. Means how many media, what is a medium length, how many wires we are using, what is the encoding technique we are using, what are the implementation type and medium, right? So you have to use this. I cannot help with it, right? So you have to, I think, I either memorize it or understand it. It's your choice. So now, any queries in this today's topic? Today, I completed the first chapter, I think. Means first chapter of module 5, that Ethernet part. So now, any query? Anyone? Yes, no, guys.